Don't be ChargePoint. Be better. We'll start with this ChargePoint Home Flex that I purchased back in April, and I was really excited about this unit because this is one of the best EVSEs on the market today for home charging. And there's a couple reasons for that. One is it's really nice size. It looks nice, has this wonderful cable management system built in, nice swiveling holster with a light, and a very nice plug. Moreover, the cord is kind of famous as being extremely flexible even when it's cold. The problem began when I bought it. I purchased this unit on eBay. That shouldn't be an issue if the thing is functional, which it was. I got it, I plugged it in, I started connecting it to my Wi-Fi, and I was going to connect to the ChargePoint network to enable the smart features, and then I got an error message. That said, this was linked to a different account. I thought, oh, great. It's a smart device. I have lots of smart devices. This happens often when I buy them on eBay used. Somebody has not unlinked them from their account. There's probably a button somewhere or some way to reset the device. I just need to do that and we're good to go. Except I couldn't find a button. And when I jumped online to figure out how to do this, I came across Reddit posts of people saying, you either have to go to the old owner to get them to take it off, or you can go to ChargePoint and ask them to reach out to the old owner to take it off. So I thought, well, I'll reach out to the people I bought it from on eBay, except they weren't the original owner. They didn't have it on their account. They were a reseller, and they didn't know who that original owner was because they bought it in a lot. So I went to ChargePoint. I explained the situation. I said, hey, can you reach out to the original owner? They said, sure. I wait a couple days. I call them back. Have you heard anything? No, we have not heard anything. We've called them. We've left them emails. A couple days go by, I go back to ChargePoint and I say, how long do we have to wait till we can assume that this previous owner is not interested and we can just get this thing reset? They said, well, we'll run it up the chain. Wait another couple days, call them back. Have you run it up the chain? Yes, but we need to verify that you actually have the physical device. Could you send us some pictures of the serial number to this non-existent email? And that at point, I just felt like they were just yanking me around. So I call back again and I say, have you heard from the owner? No, we have not heard from the owner. Can you call them again? Can you leave them a voicemail? We can't leave them a voicemail. Well, they're not going to answer the phone because people today do not answer spam from strange numbers. And your email probably went to their junk email folder. They couldn't do anything. At that point, I'm a couple weeks in. I'm calling them almost every night. I am very frustrated. The thing will charge my car. I just can't enable the smart features. So I just said, whatever. I was getting very frustrated because ChargePoint was almost insinuating that I did not own the charger because I did not have access to the software. And I was very much adamant that no, I own the charger. I paid $600 for this charger. Let me have access to my charger. No. I go on my Twitter rampage. I go on my Reddit rampage. And Reddit very much agrees with me. And they raised a few points that I wanted to raise with you all as to why I think this is a big issue. So first, what about the used market for EVSEs? I think we're just in the infancy of that. And as we go forward, it's going to get larger and larger as more and more people have electric vehicles and they trade in their EVSEs, etc. And what that means is there's going to be a lot more on eBay, a lot more people buying them on eBay. And this is going to become a very common occurrence. Second, as was pointed out by some Redditors, what about in apartment buildings where you may install this for your tenant? They may link it to their account so they can use all the features while they're living there, and then they move away. And very likely, they move away somewhere entirely different. Maybe they change their phone number, maybe their email they don't use anymore. And you have this charger sitting in your parking lot or garage that is linked to a random account and can't be linked to a new tenant. Similarly, if you own a home and you sell the home and you leave the charger in the garage, which many people will do, it's a similar situation. That person may just go away and not be heard from again, and you are left with a dumb charger. Finally, from a sustainability standpoint, this is a really silly idea because you have a charger that could be perfectly good, that could perfectly be used for many, many years to come. But now it is a dumb charger, which dramatically reduces its value and its appeal to many people who may go and buy a new unit which requires a lot of resources and materials. That's not good for the environment. On so many fronts, this does not make sense to lock people out of chargers that they have legally purchased. Now, I say legally purchased, yes, a theft could be an issue, but as of today, you know, you're talking like home burglary situations, and especially if these are hardwired in, who's going to unhardwire it off the wall and steal it? Not very common. Now, it's not just me. I have come across some other people on Reddit who have had similar issues, and many have gotten it resolved by talking to the previous owner. But I did come across a man who had a Wallbox Pulsar, and that unit was locked and Wallbox refused to unlock it until Reddit raised up in arms and got enough momentum behind it that they relented. There was some funny business there with stolen credit cards and things like that. So I think they had a little bit more legitimacy, maybe withholding things on the part of Wallbox. And kudos to them for eventually making it right. But just the level of pressure that it took to get Wallbox to release that charger to the user, in my mind, is unacceptable. And what I've had to go through with ChargePoint and still not have this thing released to me is downright unacceptable. If you have these devices out there in the world and people are buying them and reselling them, you cannot force people to be locked into a previous owner like that. Now, people will say, but it's like an iPhone, but it's entirely not like an iPhone. Your personal information is not on this device. All this device is doing is giving energy, releasing energy, really, to your car, and then reporting some of the statistics on it. There is not necessarily sensitive information on this device, nor is it a thing like your phone, which has all of your everything on it. So if Apple wants to lock your phone, that makes a lot more sense than having this be the case. So for EVSE manufacturers out there, learn from ChargePoint, don't be ChargePoint, and also be better with your customer service. ChargePoint, eventually I just felt like they were lying to me. Don't be ChargePoint, be better. And make sure that your users have a backdoor physically on the device or in some other way that they can reset these units when they arrive at a situation like this. Or institute a waiting period. They can contact you, and if you do not hear from the previous owner within a week, it can be unlocked. Some sort of policy, not just this blank wall of bureaucracy. If you've enjoyed this video, like, comment. I'm sure this could raise some comments. And I will see you guys in the next one.